Hi there, it's Babs from Fiery Phoenix, and this morning what I'm going to be showing you is how to attach buttons using your sewing machine. So to do this, you will need a button foot, which is a simple lever attachment. If you're not sure how to change the feet on your sewing machine, I've got a tutorial on that. I'll put a link in the description box below. I'm going to show you both how to sew a four-hole button and also how to sew a two-hole button, even if it's in a fancy shape. I'll start with the two-hole and then move on to the four-hole. And so I've got my double layer of fabric, which we'll just pop in. And then you place the button underneath the foot. Try and centralise the button holes. The foot itself has a rubber portion at the front. I don't know if you can see the squadginess of that foot, which is going to grip the button. We need to set a stitch length of 0, and we're going to use a zigzag stitch. So you would thread your needle and manually check the location and position of that first hole, and if you're happy with that, manually check how far across the second hole is. If we're not happy with that, we just need to lift and alter the position until we are happy. Once you've done that manually using the side wheel, then you can go ahead and sew that button in place. And that is a beautifully sewn button. It's a nice strong button. So we just snip that away, make sure there's a nice long thread, because what we're going to do is pull through the tails from the front through to the back so that that can be then knotted and tied off. And now if I move on to sewing a four-hole button rather than just a simple two-hole button, we go through exactly the same process. Line the button up, capture it with the foot, check to see what the alignment is, if that's working, and at the moment that isn't, so we need to just raise the needle and move the button until the needle goes in, and then check to see if that is going to be wide enough. It's going to be obviously too wide, so in this case you would narrow the position a couple of notches on my manual machine for the other edge of the zigzag, and we just then sew across the zigzag and then lift the foot, move everything back slightly, a little bit of a wiggle around so that we've actually got it where we want it to be, and then go through the manual process again of double checking where the holes are of the button. Because we do not want to be causing any issues when we go at speed, and then you sew another 8 or 9 stitches in place and take out your button. And that really is all there is to sewing buttons onto your fabric. And you can sew plain buttons, you can sew strangely shaped buttons, but it is really as simple as that to get your button sewn on in a nice strong way, and that's a nice fast solution. See you later. Bye. I hope you found this tutorial useful, and if you did, please can you like the video and maybe even subscribe to the channel. You can find all my contact details at the end of the video, and I hope to hear from you soon. If you have any comments or suggestions for future tutorials, please just leave a comment below. Speak to you later. Bye.